We're ready to go.
Okay. Good morning, everybody, and welcome back. Today, we're going to talk about spark plugs. Now, just a few days ago, I purchased a Husqvarna weed eater that had a brand new carburetor and brand new fuel lines and brand new filters and a brand new plug. And it looked like he'd probably bought the little Chinese kit that has the carburetor and plug and everything included, and it wouldn't start. I took the plug out and looked inside the cylinder, and the cylinder looked perfect, and put it all back together and explained to him it was probably just bad gas. But he didn't want to have anything to do with it, and he insisted that I take it. So I went ahead and purchased it from him and brought it back to the shop and put new gas in. Nothing. Didn't even try to start. We tried starter fluid. Nothing. Took it apart and looked inside the cylinder again. You know, I pulled the spark plug back out, looked inside the cylinder. And then on that second time through, when I was looking inside the cylinder, I looked at the spark plug, and then I remembered Husqvarnas need a resistor spark plug. The plug in my hand was not a resistor spark plug. What he handed me was an L7T. And on a resistor plug, there will always be an R in the designation for the plug. So I looked it up, and Husqvarna recommended the RJ6C, I believe. Or not, the RJ6Y. And so I bought the RJ6Y plug and threw it in, and it started on the first pull and ran like a champion. That was the only thing wrong with that weed eater. So when you're buying spark plugs, make sure you check what the manufacturer recommends and use that. It'll save you a lot of aggravation in the long run, and it might save you throwing away something that actually was in good shape. And remember, the spark plug is rarely the problem when you have a weed eater or something that won't start. If you want to tune it up and you feel obligated to put a new spark plug in, that's fine. Either use the manufacturer plug or cross-reference it to your favorite brand. In Husqvarna's case, they recommend a Champion 6. Now, the heat range of 6 does not cross to Bosch and NGK and all the other brands. You need to go to find yourself a conversion chart and check it. With a NGK, for instance, the smaller the number, the hotter the plug. With a Champion, the larger the number, the hotter the plug. However, when you get into some plugs, say the 56s and 57s, those are actually colder plugs. So definitely use a cross-reference chart if you decide to change from one brand to another. So let's look at a couple spark plugs and see when you'd want to change heat range. So here are a couple plugs that I pulled out of the bin. Now, every time I put a motor out into the free world and let it go up for adoption, we always replace the spark plugs and air filters and whatnot. If I look at this one, this one's just a random plug that came out of the bin, but it looks pretty nice. You can see there's no white chalky marks that would indicate the motor was running too hot, and there's no oil buildup indicating maybe a dirty air filter or a rich condition on the carburetor. Now, if we look at this one, the first thing I would think on this one is it needed a new air filter. And I'm sure the engine got one before it left, but an air filter will cause your plug to look just like this, and sooner or later it's going to start misfiring. If you look and your air filter looks good, but your plug looks like this, the second thing you'd go to is check the carburetor to see if it's running rich. You can usually tell on a two-stroke motor if a motor's running rich because it won't accelerate easily. Too rich or too lean, and they start complaining pretty quickly. So if you see something like this and the air filter looks clean, then that's the only time I would consider going with a hotter plug. Because when you go with a hotter plug, you're risking detonation, and detonation is pretty rough on an engine. Now, if you're running your plugs and you see that your motor appears to be running too rich, the first thing I would do is look at the air filter. If the air filter is dirty, if it's medium to heavy dirty, then I'd say, okay, this is probably caused by a dirty air filter. You're not letting enough air in, so your fuel mixture is off. Replace the air filter, put a new spark plug in, and call it done. Now, you don't want to change heat ranges away from manufacturer as a rule. And keep in mind, from one company to the next, the heat ranges are different. An NGK, the lower the number, the hotter the plug. A Champion, the higher the number, the hotter the plug. So if you have a favorite plug and you decide to change, make sure you use a cross-reference chart first. Most weed eater plugs are pretty much the same size, and the heat range is the big difference, and whether or not it's resistor is a difference. Always match what the manufacturer recommends for both. Troybilt will work with a resistor or a non-resistor plug just fine, but they prefer a non-resistor plug. they'll run a little bit happier, and they'll use less fuel. An Echo or a Husqvarna, they prefer a resistor plug. If you don't put a resistor plug in, most of the time they won't run at all. So I hope this was helpful. And if you have any suggestions or comments, feel free to leave them. And happy mowing.